I'm going to talk about innovation and entrepreneurship, a way out for Europe or a future for Europe. Why? We have for the last 10 years in Europe discussed problems of the Eurozone, which actually were all related to past behavior of governments and corporates, and of course also private sector. In those 10 years, the world has changed dramatically, and most in Europe are not realizing how dramatically the world has changed. The key for the future is not whether or not we will also comply with the rules of the Eurozone. We have to comply. And if you do not comply with the rules of the Maastricht, and that is of the Eurozone will not survive. At present, all members of the Eurozone are complying with the deficit rule of the 3%. Which is a result of a, from some people, tough policy in the last couple of years. But unfortunately, this was necessary in order to keep the Eurozone and with that Europe together. So actually the fact that now most, that all of them are complying is a result of a politic which basically had a focus on reducing deficits and not on increasing deficits. So it proves that probably those were wrong who said that the survival of Europe would depend on the Eurozone continuing or even increasing their budget deficits. So spending more than governments and the people were making. So we now have a policy which proves that there was never a trade-off between austerity and growth. We now have austerity, a part at least, and we have growth in the Eurozone and the EU, more than in the UK and even more than in the US. So hopefully this will end a period of 10 years or more where Europe was occupied with its own internal, rather small problems compared to those they are facing in the future, because in that 10 years, the world around Europe has changed dramatically. And one of the key issues is the emergence of Asia, and here in particular the emergence of China. When the Eurozone crisis started and became evident, GDP per capita in China was something like 5,000 euro per capita. Now it's almost 9,000, or next year will be probably close to 10,000 per capita. Just to remind you, in the 70s or early 80s, GDP per capita in China was $200 per year, and now it's almost 9,000 per year, which is an incredible dramatic rise. What are we facing? Is it simply this growth, or is it the driver of the growth? And the driver of the growth in China is more and more innovation pace. Is the pace of innovation driven by entrepreneurship and driven by people who invest in venture capital and angel investors and startup founders? We see an explosion of new firms in China. We see an explosion of venture capital, and we see an explosion of angel investing. And for the first time in 2017, already China has more venture capital per capita of the population than the EU. It had already more than the Eurozone for years, but now even higher than in the EU. What does it mean? It's an easy prediction that in 5-6 years down the road, the innovation pace in China will be substantially higher than in Europe. So the question is, has Europe a chance to keep up or not? It is not about whether a new Google will be created in Europe. It will not. This is the battle of yesterday. But we have to be looking at AI, whether we are able to invest in artificial intelligence as the Chinese do. And in 2017, there was more venture capital invested in AI in China than even in the US. It was almost 48% of the world in China, 38% of the world in the US. This is 86%. That doesn't leave a lot for the rest of the world, which is Latin America, which is Russia, which is Africa and Europe. So maybe out of a G20 world, we are moving into a G2 world, and we can only hope that maybe it will be 2.5, and the half is would be Europe. So for Europe, the key for the future is increasing innovation pace, that is to understand the importance of entrepreneurship culture and to understand the importance of an increasing number of startups. Most of them will fail, but some of them will survive. And it's the Googles and the Amazon and all these and Microsoft, and they all came out of huge numbers of startups, and a few have survived, and a few are now market leader in the whole internet business in the world. Out of the largest 20 internet firms in the world, there are 12 US, 7 China, and 1 Japan. None of them in Europe.